I'd like you to welcome now two great heroines of the Jewish community. First, Laurie Regan of EMET. Laurie Regan.
Thank you, Jeff, Helen, Richard, all of the people that have gathered here today, the organizers. On behalf of the Endowment for Middle East Truth, we greatly appreciate your presence and engagement on this very important issue. I have a blue dress, the color of the Israeli flag that I like to wear during pro-Israel rallies. But today I'm wearing black because sadly we are in mourning. We're in mourning because the New York Metropolitan Opera has chosen to murder Leon Klinghoffer a second time, almost to the day of the 29th anniversary of his death at the hands of Palestinian terrorists. But we're also mourning the death of the saying, never again. For when Peter Gelb, a Jew, chooses to produce an opera in the city with the world's largest Jewish population outside of Israel, an opera that humanizes and glorifies terrorists who murdered an innocent Jewish man whose only crime was that he chose to take his wife on a cruise ship for their anniversary, we should all mourn the sad state of our people. What do composer John Adams, Peter Gelb, and the Metropolitan Opera have in common with Yasser Arafat, Mahmoud Abbas, and the Palestinian Authority? They all choose to glorify terrorism and honor terrorists who murder Jews. When Peter Gelb produces the death of Klinghoffer, he is no different than Arafat and Abbas, who name public squares and arenas after suicide murderers who blow themselves up in order to kill as many Jews as possible. There is no moral equivalence between the terrorists who murdered Leon Klinghoffer and who blew up the Sbarro's Pizza restaurant in Tel Aviv and their tragic victims, and to suggest otherwise is simply psychotic and dangerous. And to the false narrative that somehow the murder of an innocent, disabled Jewish man can be justified by the suffering endured by his murderers, this presents a danger to all of our survival. This psychosis did not begin with the Metropolitan Opera's production of Death to Klinghoffer, but we must do our part to see that it ends here. As Israel is demonized in the world over by anti-Semitism couched as anti-Zionism, any humanization or defense of terrorism endangers not only the Jewish people on the front lines in Israel, but all of us the world over. Art is a lovely and important part of any culture, but when it becomes an excuse to replace reason and morality with insanity, we Jews have a problem. Peter Gelb is more concerned with bringing Adam's opera to the Met than he is with taking a moral stand in the fight against good versus evil. In this regard, he is no different than pre-World War II German Jews who enjoyed attending concerts, listening to compositions by the anti-Semitic Wagner, whose legacy one historian described as helping to define European anti-Semitism and dubbed is nothing less than the sweeping imprint of racial ideology across the length and breadth of modern classical music. In other words, Gelb is furthering a legacy that justifies terrorism at the expense of its innocent victims. I'm reminded of a school paper that my son wrote several years ago in eighth grade on the Israeli-Palestinian conflict. In the margin, next to the paragraph on the glorification of terrorists through the naming of streets and arenas after these murderers, his teacher, Mr. Friedman, circled the word terrorist and wrote, "Be very careful with your word choice. One country's terrorist is another's heroes." This is what our children are being taught by fellow Jews. Boo! This must end. This opera must be a wake-up call to all of us that anti-Semitism does not just exist in the Mideast and across Europe. It is being mainstreamed. It is flourishing, and it now exists in New York City opera houses in 2014. Today we are mourning, and it must end. Thank you.